It's time for Sunday Sound Off, where you and Kansas City sports luminaries weigh in on hot topics around the sports world. Everybody but me, I ask the brilliant questions. Tonight's panel answers them. Blair Kirchhoff joins us from his penthouse apartment high above Kauffman Stadium. How are you, Blair?
Doing great, Nick. How you doing?
It's a great location. Really
Thank
is.
Thank you. Yeah, I picked it out just for you.
Yeah, I can tell. Therese Paylor is the hardest working person in their newsroom, probably the only person left in our newsroom, but still hardest working. How are you, corporate champ?
Hey, I'm great. You know, I got to punch that time clock, especially after another Chiefs loss. That's just so exhilarating for these fans.
You are earning your keep,
always,
my friend. And then Soren Petro joins us from the studio because he secretly wants to be a TV guy. Am I wrong, Soren?
It's what I live for. I want to wear color-coded ties based upon who plays that night. I think that's what I've always wanted in my career.
That is that's actually step number one. If you want to be a journalist, who you cover, you got to wear that color tie. I'm red, so I'm good, I guess.
Good
all
job.
Right, guys. Wipe the smiles from your faces, okay? Let's talk some Chiefs. From 5-0 to 6-5, how do you all explain this Chiefs free fall, Blair? I mean, this could be a meltdown of historic proportions here.
It could be. Look, the Chiefs have a little bit of a history of this with Andy Reid. Not so much a meltdown, but a reversal of fortune. You remember the first year they started 9-0 and finished 2-5, I think, 2013. And then just a couple of years ago, what they started 1-5 and turned that around, won their final 10. So this is actually more a hot start or a cold start and then a hot finish. More the norm than the exception. But this feels a little different, doesn't it? The offense has just been terrible these last few weeks. I didn't think it could get any worse than it did last week in New York with the Giants, and it seemed to be worse today. 236 total yards, the lowest of the season. I thought Alex Smith was probably had his worst game today. It started with the Steelers game. The Chiefs couldn't figure out how to solve Pittsburgh once again, and it just hasn't gotten any better since then.
I mean, Therese, when did this happen? It was the Pittsburgh game at Oakland sometime later. We'll talk about the what later on, but when did this curse come about the Chiefs?
It is what Blair just said. It was a Steelers game. There was so much optimism that the Chiefs had figured out a way to kind of counteract the things the Steelers did to them in January. Then they play that game in the same location, and they get beaten many of the same ways. Take away the running game, punish Alex Smith. And since then, you've seen teams, and basically every team except Oakland and Denver, use the same formula to beat them. It's been embarrassing offensively. Let's just call it for what it is. I think it's a failure on multiple levels. It's the play calling. The quarterback play has been bad. The offensive line has been bad. It's bad basically everywhere except tight end, in my opinion.
Yeah. Soren, do you ever see anything like this? Because we talk about the 9-0 start, but I mean, this is extreme hot to extreme cold here.
It is, and I think the best example might be 14. I mean, we have seen them, you know, go one direction and then go the other. I think the time that it was going well was 14, where through 10 games they were 7-3, went out to Oakland and lost. They would lose three in a row and finish up 2-4 in their last six, be 9-7, and that's the one other year, I might say, that they didn't go to the playoffs, because they're actually trending in that direction very much so. Look, there had only been 9 teams in the history of the NFL start 5-0 and then lose at least 4 of their next 5, either lose 4 or 5 of their next 5 games. Only one of those 9 teams, the 1989 Rams, went on to make the playoffs. So based on what they had done through these 10 games, history tells us that they're going in the tank. That reality is it's the 1-4 part that's the reality of the Chiefs. So that was the popular theme. Are they really the 5-0 team, or are they the 1-4 team? And I think most of us in Kansas City wanted to hang our hat on the fact that they're really the 5-0 team, or at least that's more of who they are. And reality is those statistics say that's not the case, and they lived up to it today. I do agree. I think the Steeler game was the one that really broke their confidence, but there were signs of problem before this. Their defense was giving up a lot of yards, even in going 5-0. And the last 4 years told us that this was not the number 1 or 2 offense in the NFL that could just boat race people the way the New England Patriots do. You should have expected a market correction on offense. The problem was we expected that correction on defense, and we haven't seen that kind of major change.
All right, guys, next question. Is it time for a quarterback change in Kansas City? A lot of fans are clamoring for it. Therese, like I said, plenty of fans want one. You're closest to the players. Do you see any of them maybe wanting a change of quarterback?
I would say this. I think it's still a good sign if you're Alex Smith that none of your teammates have publicly thrown you under the bus or hinted toward wanting to do so. by saying that we need to get better at quarterback or something of that effect. Privately, there's probably frustration within the offensive skill players who aren't getting the football. And I can tell you there's frustration with the defensive players because the offense isn't carrying its weight right now. I think in general, I think if there are some concerns about Alex internally, they'll probably stay that way, just given the way these players and this team has historically conducted business. But it is absolutely at a point where Alex needs to bounce back. Remember, 1-5 in their last six, that's the same kind of start they got off to in 2015 when they turned things around. Yeah. So one more loss is 1-6, and now people are just starting to say, okay, can he come back?
Yeah, Seren, you're president of the Pat Mahomes fan club, okay? You hold weekly meetings in your basement and everything. But there's a time for this. Does it make sense now to maybe start his era?
Let me make clear. It is time to ask the question. And for the fans that respond with the blasphemy that paint you as a guy who thinks Pat Mahomes is, I got this tweet today. Because I said, when do you make the change? If you're going to make a change, when do you make it? Simply asking the question, and the response I got from one fan was, well, you think Pat Mahomes is Tom Brady? No, I never mentioned Tom Brady. That's not what I think. But unfortunately, that's the corner that people get painted into. If you even ask the question about making a change, you're somehow saying Alex Smith is the worst quarterback that ever lived and Patrick Mahomes is the best. That's not the case. Big boy teams, big boy organizations, billion-dollar organizations have to ask themselves tough questions. And this question should absolutely be asked in the meeting rooms right now. Now, is it the time? I think we're one game short. I think the time would have been to go with the kid to start the year. That's when I would have gone with Patrick Mahomes. That looked very silly at 5-0. I think now is the time to ask the question. And I think reality is if you fall to 500 or lose control of first place, then it's absolutely time to make a change.
All right, Blair, how different would you expect it if Mahomes stepped in right now?
It'd be different for sure, but think about this. Remember they gave Pat Mahomes some snaps with the first team offense in the preseason. Yep. He actually looked pretty good with that. But on the other side, I will say this. Keep in mind the team that the Chiefs played today, the Buffalo Bills, and what they tried to do a week earlier when they went with their rookie quarterback. I'm not trying to compare fifth-round pick Nathan Peterman to first-round pick Patrick Mahomes, but it was a disaster for the Buffalo Bills a week ago. What Peterman had, five picks in the first half?
In the first half, yeah.
Before they had to get him out of there. Again, it's not a direct comparison, but that's just a cautionary tale of what could happen.
Let's put out the optimistic tale is Dak Prescott. It's Deshaun Watson. There is a recent history of successful rookie quarterbacks. I agree. It may go in the toilet if you go down that direction, but it also might work. You did give up two first-round picks for the guy. You didn't draft him in the fifth round.
Yeah. Therese, you're shaking your head. What do you have to say on last one on the subject?
I think when there's going to come a point where the benefit to starting Patrick Mahomes outweighs the concern about it. And actually, I think it might be after next week or 2 weeks from now. If this team looks like the point where they're not going to make the playoffs, I think that's the point where you start playing for the future with the kid. But there's still a pretty good chance that these guys can find a way to bounce back. Remember, they still got those two games against Oakland and the Chargers. Oh, yeah. They win those games. They win the division or in the playoffs.
All right, quickly here, guys. It's a question we never considered several weeks ago. Will the Chiefs make the playoffs? Seren, you're up first. Just a game ahead of two teams now in the division.
Yeah, look, I think Andy Reid's the real deal, and I think they will get it done. I think they'll find enough. They're not getting blown out of these games. So, yes, I think they have the pieces to get it done. So simple answer, yes, they've still got the lead. They've got home games left against division opponents. They damn well better make the playoffs.
Blair, and Seren mentioned this stat earlier. I think it's 5-0 teams twice in kind of the modern era have missed the playoffs. Vikings did it just last year. They had quarterback issues with it, but that would be almost unheard of.
Falcons did it in 2015 as well. Broncos in 2009. So, yeah, there is precedent for it. No, I say they don't make the playoffs. I think that I thought they would react so much differently today after the Giants game. I was really surprised that they played as poorly as they did today.
Therese, the good news is the AFC West, I guess. Does 8-8 get them in at this point? I mean, what's the number there?
I don't know if 8-8 gets them in, but I do think they'll make the playoffs. Andy Reid has a history of helping this team bounce back through adversity. If you base it on that, you got to give them the benefit of the doubt.
All right, great stuff, guys. Up next, MU fans want Drew Locke to stay, and KU fans want David Beatty to go. Will either one be happy? Stay with us.